Arun Rathi, and let me help you with your questions in this email. So, you know, it would be much better instead of typing a lot. I would be able to cover it much in details, right? Hope you can understand me. So here you go. So he said he was a beginner, still working on designing new product and breed campaigns. We'll have some potential ads ready. I'll send you before. All right. Of course, when I should cancel, no same like all of them. See, if you are running a small ad set for, let's say, $3 budget, $3 budget is pretty fair. So let's say if we launch these campaigns today on Monday and we run it till Saturday, that's like 6 days. So on one campaign, you're going to spend $18. And if you didn't get any sales on the $18, or there is not much engagement on the post, you know, sometimes sales are slow. But if your post is getting engagement, your ad post on your Facebook page is getting engagement, it's getting a lot of likes, shares, or people tagging people, that means eventually it is going to give you a lot of sales. You know, see, there are like thousands of posts that people post on Facebook. However, not everyone is viral. So over the time, you're going to find some viral and some super viral post. These are the posts that people, these are the products that people would love based on the specific breeds, because you know, every breed, they have different community, they have different kind of charities in USA. So it all depends on the design that they're gonna like. But $3 is definitely not too small, but make sure you let it run for at least 6 days before you decide to kill it or scale it. Okay, so if in $18 you get one sale, even just one sale, then that would be enough for it to run for the next week. Okay, so yes, $3 is not too small, and you can definitely run per campaign. Okay, so 8 campaigns for $3 would be like $24 per day. Okay, so this is how you gotta do, not less than $3 for one specific campaign. Okay, so next question is, you say, when looking at my ad manager, I notice there's a page post to polish.com. It should be pause and crosspride.com, not polish.com. If you're seeing that, then my apologies, it should not be like that. Okay, please edit it, change it to pause and crosspride.com. It should reflect your website. Okay, you should get all the sales. Can you help me explain? Not sure, it's a mistake. So yes, let me check the screenshot also where you say that. I'm sorry. That's totally a wrong post. Please ignore it, or wherever you see that, delete it. Okay, that's a totally wrong, incorrect ad post. I don't know how it came in there. All right, so next one, you say, when in the account overview, when I see the current campaigns, why do some have purchases under the result column and some have view content? Are there purchases? I can see every one of them should have purchase. Once again, if you see a view content when you're starting out, it doesn't matter so much. But at the end of the day, our goal is to get a purchase. So if you see view content, then go ahead and edit it and make it purchase. Okay, because we are aiming for purchase only. Some people, they start with view content in order to, for Facebook to get them more traffic, you know, because when you're starting out, first thing you need to get on your website is the traffic. Sales is something that's going to come back later on. All right, but as a rule of thumb, always optimize for purchase. Okay, how long do you recommend the ads for each campaign before we decrease? This is what I just covered. Give it a 6 days. Always launch your ads on a specific day of a week. You know, don't do it every day, because you know, Facebook is a big software. Millions of advertisers are advertising on it. So whenever you make a change to your Facebook campaign, so somehow it also affect the results, the traffic of other campaigns too. See, I'm doing Facebook advertisement from past 5 years. So over the time, I learned this, that any changes you're making to at the account level, even it's not related to a specific campaign, then also it affects other campaigns. So what I personally do is I launch campaign on one specific day of a week, that is Monday, and let them run it till Sunday or Saturday, up to you. And then on Sunday night, you can see which one performed pretty good. Okay, because then you have a data, you gave it a time, you gave it a money, you gave it a budget to run. Then you as a businessman, as a Facebook advertiser, you can decide which one to kill. You can easily see that, okay? In starting, sales are not everything, engagement also matters, okay? And once again, engagement is all about how many reactions you are getting to the post, the comments, reaction. I can see on the page that you have got pretty good comments. That means things are rolling. They are slow, of course, because our budgets are less, but we are not going to increase it yet. We will let it go like this, okay? Next is, look like I am spending $30 per day, 5 per time, like 6 campaign, okay? There's a lot to me with not a lot of click. So should I consider stop all of these? Focus on, once again, budget is something that you need to decide. See, whenever someone asks me about the budget, it all depends on how much you're willing to invest. Because in the starting, see, if your pixel, I think I've discussed pixel with you, if your pixel is very new, then Facebook definitely takes some time to decide which particular product or what kind of traffic they should send to your website. All right, so this is something that you cannot rush, because this is how it works. So if $30 per day is too much for you, then you can take it to the $3 per day into 6 campaigns. And if you think that, you know, running an ad which is not making you much money for 6 days is too much, then again you can do it 3 days, because you have an advantage of over 4,000 products on your store. So you can kill them fast, test more, kill them fast, test more. You can do that, okay? So it's not necessary you can run it for a week. If your budget doesn't allow that, then make it 3 days, okay? So from Monday to Wednesday, let it run. On Thursday, check which one made you a sale and which doesn't. And the one who doesn't made a sale and doesn't have a much engagement, just kill it, pause it, all right? So next you're saying is there a way to have all the campaign in the grand total budget on Facebook? Say I want to spend up to $300 and add on all campaign. No, actually there's no such option. Every campaign is a separate campaign and you need to define a budget on campaign levels. You cannot do it on the complete account level, all right? But what you can do is there is a specific option called, if you want to run an ad from Monday to Saturday and you don't want to run it Sunday, then you can schedule those ads from specific dates with a budget. For example, you can schedule it from today to, let's say, Saturday, and give it a budget for like maybe like $20. Then Facebook will decide itself that how much it need to spend every day, all right? But at the end of the time, you can expect $20 to spend, all right? This is what you can do. Then how do the reach, impression, link, clicks and purchase compare to the other clients, the similar campaigns almost a week? Well, James, this is a factor that depends on a lot of things, because once again, millions of people are advertising on Facebook with you. So it depends on a specific day and a specific time, how many people are targeting the same interests as you are targeting. So although they don't have a high quality, high targeted product like the Breed Business product, but they could be promoting something else. For example, suppose you are promoting something to the Pugs lover or the Labrador Retriever dog lovers, then although not everyone have access to the products you have, but they have their own products. They can be promoting something from the website like AliExpress. They might be promoting something from let's say Amazon.com or their own store, or they might have their own unique product like their white label product. So this all depends on the specific day and specific time and how many advertisers are competing for a specific thing. There is no criteria for that, all right? And we don't want to complicate it. It doesn't matter about link, click, purchases, impression or reach, all right? Or although there is a way that reach is something that, you know, suppose you want to sell something out, then at least you would expect like 500 to 1000 people should see your ad, because not everyone is a buyer, right? So we need to give Facebook a time, of course, to show your ads. So in the reach, at least in the reach level, you should aim for 1000 people, 1000 unique reach, all right? And it should be slow, not like a big budget per day, rather than a very small budget per day. All right, page boost, traction. Why exactly a page boost? Page boost is nothing. It actually works more of a way when suppose your page have a 1000 of likes and you post something on your page. So previously, like post 2012, when you have a page and you post something on Facebook, then Facebook used to show that particular thing to everyone who liked your page. But now it's changed. Currently, Facebook gonna throw like 100 or 200 impressions. It is going to show your post to 100 or 200 people, and based on their reaction, like how much they like the post, how much they're engaged to it, they show it to more people. So boost, page boost is an option by which you're asking Facebook to automatically Alright, so wait a second, I was just testing out some stuff. Let me get back to it. Here we are. Okay, so in the page boost option, it just shows your product to the people who have liked your page. Okay, in my testings, I didn't find it much useful. I have pages which have like 500,000 users. I mean, the people who have liked them. Even I have page with a million plus reach, but for some reason, this didn't work much better for me. Okay, so again, you know, you should always be open for testing. You need to decide your way, the way you want to go. But if you're asking me, my experience, that I don't use it. All right, the next point is general ads or business-based content. Do we ever do general ads that could target, say, dog? Or does it have to always target by the breed? See, its answer is pretty simple. You know, James, suppose you own a dog. Of course, if you own a dog, you own a specific breed, right? You're going to own a chihuahua or maybe a pug. So if I own a pug, then typically, you know, we're like known as the pug dad or pug mom. So I would be more interested to see content about my pug, right? I would be less interested to see what you're selling. You know, why would a pug lover would buy a Labrador Retriever shoes? In general sense, it doesn't make sense. So I think it would be less targeted, although you're going to get a cheaper engagement, but the target would be too less. And I don't see if it could generate a lot of sales. Showing the specific ad to specific breed owner makes more sense, right? But again, if you want to test, you can put a $5 budget and test it out. Maybe you might find it, you know, something pretty cool. But in general terms, I don't think it makes sense. Okay. All right. In 6P, you're asking, could we have something, our business page, that show more general, which would help with the branding too? I noticed the screenshot of that has polished my store. You may try to have an overall message for all product. Okay, could we have something on our business page that shows more general overall products? More general overall product, which would help with the branding too? Well, in this case, what you can do is you can actually post a video on your page. You know, you can go to the post setting, go to video, and there you can upload multiple images. You can upload up to 18 different images, and Facebook convert that images into a slideshow style video. So this is the way you would be able to see multiple share multiple breeds, like as a general store, you know, a general different product on a single video. So you can post like 4 or 5 videos, this covering 18 to 20 images each. So you're covering like 100 products. That's the way you can do that. Okay, it's pretty easy to create Facebook slideshows in the post option. That is the way I think it can work. All right. So also, some of the other videos you previously shared suggested that we are not getting anywhere. We should just killing the ad. Okay. A website. I wanted my website professional. Is my, I wonder if more large banner, large logo, again the security seal. Could we also add a manufacturer video? Manufacturer video, yes, I can do that for you. That's not a problem. It would just need some time because, you know, I need to hire a video editing team. I don't have it in-house, but not a problem. I can do that for you on the homepage. See, once again, James, the point is when you're sending traffic from your Facebook ad to your website, then you are sending it to a specific product page. And the website that you can see right now, it's been tested with over $100,000 in sales in past. Everything that you see on your website is the result of our tried and tested methods. You know, things there are not random. I have started the whole thing in January last year. So it's like almost 1.5 years since, you know, the Breed Business website is going on. I started offering it in October, but I was personally doing it from January 2017. So I did a lot of tweaks and changes to the website, and the one you see right now is the one that could give pretty good conversions. But you cannot decide that yet, because you need to send at least 1,000 people should have seen your website. Only then we can judge it, you know. We cannot judge it with a very less traffic. All right. So exactly, that's what you have said, right? I think any enhancement to website can't hurt, but with not enough click yet, maybe. Exactly, that's the point. We need to, in this particular year, you're correct about it, we need to get more people to the website first, you know. Only then we can judge how it is working. All right. And the good thing is, because under your plan you still have Amazon and eBay add-ons yet to go, so we didn't forget that. This is something that we need to focus on later on, but these things, when they mix together, they create a complete system. Okay, so do not worry about it. Let's just go with it, and then you see, ad itself should be considered to try video and other images. Of course you can do that. You can simply try slideshow videos or different images. You can do that, no issues. Landing pages, do we need to something other than the business? You don't need to do it yet. Okay, engagement ads, some videos suggest. Once again, I'm not going to stop you from any of these things, right? See, Facebook ad is open to all. It's a general platform. The more you do, the more you learn. All right, so if you want to do these things, go ahead and do it. What the maximum thing would have happened is like investment of more money, but again, you will learn something out of it. So I won't say no to any of these, right? You can definitely do it, or you can simply go with the, you know, with a basic setup. Price, could price be too high? That's why no price is not too high, because your store didn't receive much of a traffic. So we cannot judge it if price is high or not. Right now they're like merely 100 visitors or 200 visitors. I don't know what's the number your store have, but it's pretty less right now. So we cannot judge the pricing factor right now. But the price you can see there is, they're already tested in different stores and they're working pretty well. You don't need to find a way to get a more click. There are no ways for that. You simply need to launch more campaign and you need to invest more money in ads. That's the only possible way. Because if a particular targeted audience like the product image or the product video in their news feeds, then they're going to click on it, and not everyone is going to click on it. So the best possible way to get more click is to launch more campaigns. As simple as that, to cover different products, different breeds. Cover cat breed, cover hamster, horse, and different breed apart from dogs. All right. Are these ads seen? Yes, the most of the traffic that your store receives is from the mobile device. Almost 75% traffic today available using Facebook ads is from mobile, not from desktop. Okay. No, I don't see anything as such. Your ads are completely configured for mobile. There's no issue with that. Well, every product in TBB catalog get a sale, but right now I can say car seat covers are doing pretty good, and then the mobile wallet covers, I don't know if it's like completed on all stores or not, but mobile wallet covers are pretty good. They're like over 600 designs. They're amazing, beautiful designs, and they cover almost, I think, 30 or 40 models of mobile phones, all the popular one, iPhone, iPhone X, iPhone 7, etc. So they're doing pretty good. And sneakers are always evergreen product, you know. When do you recommend we do eBay and Amazon? That is, I'm going to cover later on. That is something, just for your information, we're already doing it in the background. We need to prepare products before listing on these platform. Okay. So this is under process right now. The client, your product edit will be the hottest products are. No. Again, the hottest products, simple, everything that sell is a hottest product. There are no specific category of hottest products, because it all depends on the one you're promoting, and all depends on the design, if the specific targeted audience, they like the design or not. Every product created in the catalog is the hot product, but every design may not be a hit. Okay, so there's nothing much of the hot product, but of course whenever we launch a new product, then it is recommended to give it a test, the new one, because no one is doing that, right? No one is producing these kind of design in such a quantity, so you have a leverage for that. You know, create ad with confidence. Oh, that's great. That is what I expect from you. I'm sure you're doing great about it. Okay, and all right. I guess that will be all. So that's all from my side. If you have any question, then feel free to email me back. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.